God bless you as you've tuned in to the Word of His Kingdom. And my co-host is Dr. Eficio and Dr. Lorna Baldonado, and I am Dr. Lorella Meyer. But most of all, we want to introduce Jesus. We're just a team that wants to introduce Jesus. And there has been a cry all through the centuries, Lord, deliver us, deliver us, deliver us from evil, deliver us from the snares of the fowler, deliver us. And back in the time when it was the fullness of time, God knew the perfect time to send Jesus. Galatians chapter 4 brings that out. In the fullness of time, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law. So he left heaven's glory to be born, humble himself in a stable. Can you imagine? The very Son of God, God the Son, emptied himself to become the Son of God. And he was co-equal to the Father, but he said, I will come as a man. And in all points, he was tempted like we are, and yet without sin. So truly, one who was a deliverer, went through everything, felt our pains, felt our heartaches. And so the cry was, and why was it at that particular time, Rome was the most powerful nation on earth and had conquered many nations. But also Rome was the first one to build really wonderful roads where the gospel could go forth. There was the highways had opened up to the nations where the gospel could go forth. And many other circumstances that fit the season at the time when Jesus should come. Jesus is coming back again. And so we know that the Lord is orchestrating things. And we're seeing the Lord also said that much evil would come, much snares of false prophets, false Christs, wars, rumors of wars, and betrayals and all these kinds of things. But I want you to know that God is a deliverer, even to this very present day. Go ahead.
You know, I love this book of Psalm 124. 124 just opens our understanding to exactly what is going on in this time. That if the Lord himself has not been on our side, I don't know what would have become of every Christian in this hour. Things are no more the way they used to be. The enemy's antics seems to have increased. Wickedness has multiplied. Evil has been unleashed from the pit of hell. The enemy is in a hurry because he knows his time is short. The storm has been released. The tsunamis. The wicked altars are raised all over the place. The rivers are overflowing his banks. And Psalm 124, David cried out, if the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say, if the Lord had not been on our side when men attacked us, when their anger flamed against us, they would have swallowed us alive. You must agree with me, there's been an increase in frustrations. If the people who hear the word of God can be so frustrated, how much more those that do not even know the word of the Lord? Right. So that tells you that there's an increase in frustration, and also there's an increase in trap Satan. When Jesus Christ was baptized, the enemy right away laid and set traps for him.
Right.
And so the day you gave your life to Christ, the enemies just sent for the flowers, the flowers. The flowers began to set traps. Who are the flowers? They are the professional bird catchers. The enemy has released and unleashed his bird catchers to begin to catch the souls or arrest the souls of men, and the traps are set. And so every child of God needs to be very careful at this time, because the same antics of the enemy, the same traps he set for Lord Jesus Christ, using the same three things, he's still using. The pride of life, the lust of the flesh, the lust of eyes. And these things, the enemy's traps are all over the place. So for some of us, he's attacked us with poverty, and he throws out the carrots or the corn. And the moment you go out to grab the corn, he unleashes and releases, he spreads out his nets. And so many children of God have been entrapped. And that's why there's so much talk about money in the body of Christ, that we have allowed the God of Mammon to take a place amongst us, that we're losing focus because the trap of the enemy has enlarged itself and we are almost caught. But if it was not the Lord on our side, we wouldn't be here sitting talking about God. So there is still hope for God's children today, that the flood would have engulfed us, the torrent would have swept over us, the raging waters would have swept us away. But praise be to the Lord, who has not let us be torn by their teeth. We have escaped like a bird out of the flower's snare. The snare has been broken, and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Today, God is saying to us, the snare is broken. So it doesn't matter how much you've been trapped. It doesn't matter where the enemy have dumped you. It doesn't matter your soul, where it's locked up in the prison yard of the wicked, be it in the coven of the witches, be it in the altar of the wicked ones. We don't care where it is that your soul has been locked up, but there is a way of escape, because God said the snare is broken. And he has the power to break the snare of the fowler. Woman of God.
You know, once again, I'm going to go back to Luke 4:18 because I am so excited. You know, I'm excited about today because we live in a dispensation of power, beloved. And Jesus came to do something very powerful. And he said, when he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and she talked about his baptism, and because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, and he hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted. That's why we're here. He said, to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives.
Right.
And the recovering of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised. So we're here to preach deliverance. Because Jesus, God Almighty, sent his word to heal and to deliver us. So as she was saying, she said, there's always traps. And there's always things that the enemy will try to get you to fall for. That's been since the beginning of time, since he deceived Eve. There was always something to bring deception. And man is always there to try to deceive. That's why it's so important that we be aware, that we walk in the Spirit, that we take the Word of God and be doers of the Word. Mm-hmm. God has shown me in this hour, he showed me as a minister, there are so many that hear the Word, but they don't do it. They don't do anything about it. And the more that you walk in the Word, you'll know when something's not right. Because you see, the minute that you hear it, the more truth you have in you, when you hear air, you'll know it's not true. And when you walk in the Spirit, you can't be deceived. Now, in the flesh, you can be deceived. I have seen powerful ministries fallen because they got in that flesh. And they fail, maybe through a relationship. They fail through money. They fail through things. We've seen it.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we've seen it. Mm. And once again, we're not here to condemn, because we said God is a restorer, and we believe it. But there's always traps being set. That's why the Lord gave us warnings. He said, come out from among them and be ye separate. Didn't mean that we wouldn't be around ungodly people at sometimes, because sometimes in our own family. But when you come out from among them, you don't partake. You're hearing the Word of God. You're letting the Word of God go within you. And that will give you something to base. What's wrong? What's right? And when you hear that voice that doesn't come from God, sometimes it's that still, small voice of the Holy Spirit. It's a warning. I've been there before where I've heard God say something and it's like a warning. Mm-hmm. And so he doesn't want us to be deceived anymore. He came to bring deliverance. Right. So as you continue to listen to this message today, know that it's not condemnation. It's not to make you fear. We're here to lift you up. This is a word of his kingdom. Right. We're here to bring you out of that and say that this word, this Bible, and by the way, there's a Bible university.
Yes.
Dr. Lorella, would you like to tell them about that?
Yes. By all means, End Time Ministries International Bible University. and these wonderful women of God, Dr. Ificio and Dr. Lorna Maldonado, and Dr. Shaneri. Sometimes I have a hard time remembering the two, but now, now it's there. But they're wonderful, beautiful women of God that speak the spirit of revelation of what God is doing. And so it's an accredited university, and you will certainly find truths that you never thought you could understand as you begin to study the Word of the Lord, and you will become mature in Him, all because you've made yourself available to learn the Word of the Lord. So I would encourage you, if you want to, definitely get in touch with us. You can call this number, call 805-825-7932, 805-825-7932. God bless you. Amen. All right, go ahead, since I already talked.
Praise the Lord. I was just thinking about an awesome character in the Bible that we really have to look at his life. You know, back to what my sister was saying, with the times that we found ourselves, that let he that thinketh his stand take heed. That even in the midst of this evil going on, we can still distinguish ourselves. We were talking about restoration, which means God is still restoring even in the midst of the things going on. We are still being restored, but we cannot be restored except we distinguish ourselves. Daniel was in the land of captivity with his brethren, but he was picked out. He was singled out. He was singled out and made a leader, which necessitated brought about envy, jealousy, that led them to set a trap for him. I mean, if you distinguish yourself in this time, I want to say there's going to be envy from those who have not or not standing right. And when that comes, have it in mind, they're going to lay snares. They're going to set traps. So if you are one who has distinguished himself, even in this, or herself in this time, and you're living right, despite what's going on around you, you have refused to eat the king's portion, I want to encourage you today to know that the snare of the fowler, even if they trap you in it, God's mighty hand is going to deliver you. And that takes us to the book of Daniel chapter 6. And then we're made to understand that the king, Darius here, appointed 120 satraps to rule throughout the kingdom. And Daniel, because of what God had used him to do, had been honored, elevated from a position of slave to one of honor. And now he found himself amongst the leaders. But because there's something that I saw that really touched me, the Bible says in verse 4 here, it says, verse 3 says, now Daniel so distinguished himself among the administrators and the satraps by his exceptional qualities that the king planned to set him over the whole kingdom. Oh, wow. I mean, we're talking about restoration. This is what God is about to do. God is about to restore the glory of the church. God is about to restore honor to the church. So many countries are going through ethnic cleansing. Nigeria is witnessing such right now. There's ethnic cleansing going on in Nigeria. The jihadists, the terrorists are killing people, Christians, in numbers. And one thing I do know is that God is allowing for all things works together for good. God is allowing the leaders, the church leaders, to wake up from their highway of looking for money. Now they're crying out to God, and I know that God is about to restore, but the way God will restore is that we have to distinguish ourselves. The Bible says that he, by his exceptional qualities, where was he? He was in the land of captivity. So it doesn't matter where you find yourself, you can still distinguish yourself. And when you distinguish yourself, you will be picked from amongst them. And the king was planning to make him the leader, which was what brought about. He said, at this, the administrators and the satraps tried to find grounds to charge him against Daniel in his conduct of government affairs. But they were unable to do so. They could find no corruption in him. Are you a leader? Are you a minister? Are you a believer? Are you corrupt? Are you a believing unbeliever? You go to church, you still do the things that you do. You're falling into the snare of the fowler. You go in and out of the church in the morning, on Sunday mornings, you're a Christian. In the night, you are not a Christian. You're a hypocrite. God is calling that we can distinguish ourselves. You make excuses and say, you don't understand, it's because I cannot feed my family. You don't understand, I'm adding figures because I cannot do this. You don't understand because of what my husband is doing and my wife is doing. That is the reason. There is no justification. No. This is a good example of a man who was in a land of captivity, in a land of hopelessness, in a land of bondage, and he distinguished himself, and envy came. Finally, this man said, we will never find any basis for charges against this man, Daniel, unless it has something to do with the law of his God. If the enemy is setting me up, setting you up in this hour, based on the law of our God, so be it. For the same God will with a mighty hand deliver us. I say to you, the snare of the fowler is all over the place. It can come from your marriage. It can come, the devil can use food. It can use money, it can use honor, it can use glory, it can use anything. Whatever he's using, make up your mind that you're going to be distinguished in this hour. That even your enemies have set the trap and said, no, we can't get him in any other thing, but rather the law of his God. And that guarantees you your restoration and your freedom in the name of Jesus.
You know, growing up in church, we used to hear the song, I've got a made-up mind. My mind is fixed like a flint. In other words, when you make up your mind, you're going to serve God no matter what. It doesn't mean the enemy won't come. It doesn't mean that things won't try to attack you. But God will watch over you. He will bring deliverance. When you walk in the ways of the Lord and you're baptized in the Holy Spirit, and I feel that we're supposed to pray for the baptism of the Holy Spirit, because you can't walk in this power that has been taught, we talked about today, that each one has been talking about the deliverance, the power, all these things without the baptism and the Holy Spirit, because it's God's power in you. And it's called, and it's the fruit of the Spirit and the gifts of the Spirit. Discernment is one of them, will help you. So I want to pray right now, if you're watching, I'm going to pray for the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, this is for those of you that are born again. Now, the prayer went forth and you received the Lord today. Dr. Lorella led you in prayer to be born again. And I'm praying for those that have never been baptized in the Holy Spirit, right, with the evidence, not just of speaking in tongues, that will come forth, but the evidence of power, beloved, power to live for God. In the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, you are the one that sends the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I pray for those that are listening today that may be struggling with sin. They may be out there in ungodly relationships and wanting to get out, crying to get out, but can't because they're just overwhelmed. I pray, Father God, that the power of the Holy Spirit comes upon them and within them, that you would fill them with your Holy Spirit, and they will get up from that ungodly relationship. They will get up from whatever place that they're in that they know that they shouldn't be, and just walk out. For the he sikulera la maha sikura the maha. I thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for the power of the Holy Spirit that's filling them now. Beloved, if you're listening, receive it. Because you have a made-up mind. You say, I want to serve you, God. I want to live for you. And I need power in my life. In Acts 8:1, it says that the power of the living God, in Acts 1 and 8, I'm sorry, but in the name of Jesus, as you receive this power now, to walk in the ways of God. And he will bring great deliverance, great power, that will allow you to be able to walk in this world, but not live in a corruption, not be untainted by the world. Because I see a people that are being risen up to walk in holiness. Because what is holiness? Holiness isn't because you don't do this and don't do that and don't smoke and don't drink. All of those things you won't do. But what's holiness? It's the spirit of holiness, beloved, that comes from the power of the Holy Spirit that lives his life in us, through us, and for us. When you walk in the Spirit, there's no flesh. That's holiness, beloved. And I know that God is causing you to hear this today, to encourage those that feel like you've been entrapped by the enemy, that you're in a situation. I've known people that have come to me for prayer and they say, I feel I'm being trapped and I don't know how to get out. I want to get out, but I can't. The answer, beloved, is to make this affirmation. Oh, Lord, I'm going to live for you no matter what. If I have to leave this relationship, I'm going to leave it. Right. Whatever the situation might be, if you have to give up something, do it to live your life for God. Because I'm telling you, I promise you, these ministers would agree with me. I promise you, there's a reward for those that live for God. God bless you.
That was powerful. These are powerful women of God, and I thank God how the Lord speaks to them through the Word. But in Psalm 126, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, Zion is, of course, we know, it's God's people back then and God's people today. We are God's people. We are the Israel of God who have received the Lord Jesus Christ. Then we are of the seed of Abraham. And we can be in captivity. The Christian can be in captivity. We could have fallen for the snare of the fowler. But if we look to Jesus, when the Lord turned again the captivity, there's a song, there's a rejoicing, there's a liberty, there's a freedom. Then was our mouth filled with laughter. The joy of the Lord from that moment on becomes our strength. We're not going to be ensnared again. We're going to keep our eyes upon the Lord. And so our tongue was singing, praise the Lord. Then said they amongst the heathen, and that's for the unsaved, for those that don't know Jesus, the Lord had done great things for them. And so as the church is freed from captivity and begins to move in the power of the Spirit, but I'm going to add something else, and the love of God, because it's faith that works by love. Because though I have the gift of faith, though I have the gift of prophecy, and have not love, I'm nothing. So God is restoring love back to the church. And when we begin to love our enemies, when we begin to pray for those who despitefully use us, we're going to find a change in our lives. We're going to find hope restored once again. We're going to find a little crack in the prison wall. And if we recall the Bible account of how Silas and Paul, they were indeed in stocks and bonds. I mean, they could have had everything to feel sorry for themselves and lament and cry and say, well, I served God all my life. How come this is happening? No, they realized that God had a plan, and they never kept their eyes off of the Lord. They began to rejoice, and they begin to sing, and it was wonderful. It is wonderful. We were like those who dreamed, and joy is restored. We're free. We're out of our captivity, and it's going to affect those who do not know the Lord. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the streams of the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goes forth weeping, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing their sheaves with him. So once we're out of captivity, we're restored, we're wiser. We have an ear more toward the Lord instead of those things that would cause us to wander off into the snare of the fowler. Dr. Ificho.
You know, I'm going to now pray for as many of you that have been ensnared by the enemy and you've been finding it difficult to come out from this snare. When a man is entrapped or snared, he cannot help himself. He can only be helped by another through the power of the Holy Ghost. And today we are full of the Holy Spirit. For this reason, we were called and sent to this place in this hour, that we may speak the word of deliverance over your life in the name of Jesus. And I decree this day in the mighty name of Jesus that as many as been ensnared by the words of unrighteous decrees, the tongue of men, the tongue of the wicked, the tongue of violence, the words of the evil men, the unrighteous words, those that have been entrapped by your holy alliances, this day we decree that the judgment of the Lord will be released upon the altar that have held you bound to loose you and let you and set you free and liberty in the name of Jesus. The word of God says in the book of Ezekiel chapter 13, that the women make kerchiefs and they trap souls. This then will decree freedom for as many as whose souls have been trapped. Let the souls of men begin to escape like a bird from the snare of the fowler. And you say, I don't want to do, but I found myself doing. Yes, you have been locked up and been trapped. Your soul is probably tied up in the coven of the wicked. The word of God said in the book of Ezekiel chapter 11 verse 2. It said that this city shall no longer be a cauldron and the people shall no longer be meat. The cauldron is a big pot that witches used to cook human beings. But this they will decree, as the Lord God himself said, the cauldron shall be taken outside the city gate, and your soul will begin to escape. But the Bible says, even the legal captive shall be delivered, and the prayer of the mighty will be taken away from his hands. This they will decree the freedom of as many as been ensnared by the enemy. The book of Psalm 140, David was one man who had so many encounters with the traps of the enemy. But he happened to be snared by one. And that was the one that is still causing trouble in his house up to today. The snare of the adultery with Bathsheba, the wife of Uriah, that led to murder. And I pray this, that as many as been snared through their eyes by the enemy, that the enemy is bringing destruction to your family. This day, let the yoke of that curse be broken over your life in the name of Jesus. And that's why he wrote so much about traps and snares. In Psalm 140 verse 1, he says, rescue me, O Lord, from evil men. Protect me from the men of violence who devise evil plans in their hearts and stay up war every day. And they make their tongues as sharp as a serpent. And that's why I pray for you that every evil tongue that has been ensnared, to you. There are words that have been spoken into the lives of so many of us. Those words are working. Those words have kept so many destinies down. Those words said, you will not amount to anything. That is the snare. This day we decree that the cause that works with that snare be broken over your life in the name of Jesus. And any altar that those snares, those words are coming from, we set them on fire in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree that this is the Lord God himself who will keep his hand. Keep them with the hand of the wicked. The Lord will protect us from violent men. The Lord will destroy the power of the hideousness of the proud man. The Lord himself will spread out the cords of their nets. The Lord will cause their nets to be catch fire. The Lord will destroy their nets. The Lord himself will set us outside the path of the snare of the wicked. In the name of Jesus, Psalm 91, finally, verse 3 says, surely he will save you from the fowler's snare. I pray this day that the Lord God will save us from the fowler's snare. The snares of the fowler is all over the place. And remember, the fowler is a professional. The fowler has mastered the art of catching souls. But I decree this day the freedom of every soul that's been caught by the fowler this day. In the name of Jesus, receive the freedom. For he who the Son of God has set free is indeed free. Receive your freedom, and the Lord will bless you. In Jesus' name.
Amen. We just want to close. Always remember, the key is the Word of God. You can't be delivered without God's Word. Get in a good Bible teaching church, Bible study, or call and get in a university. Learn the Word, because the Word, the truth, is going to make you free. God bless you.
And whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You are freed by the power of the Word of the Lord. And please do call the Cross Television Station. Let us know what we can do for you, how we can help you through prayer, intercession, encouragement. We want to do this for you, to see God move in your lives. We love you. God loves you. We love you. That's the way it's going to be. God loves you. We love you. That's for the world to see. Until next time, God bless.